ました、大きな津波が2波3波に確認してできますかでしょうか、大きな津波が、何波にも分けて迫っております。白波を立てて、砂浜へ向けて押し寄せているのが確認できます。
You are looking at pictures of a whirlpool off the northern coast of Japan being formed right now. We want to talk to Dr. Michio Kaku about that. But first, Elizabeth, as we feared, this death toll of a devastating earthquake is rising in Japan.
We knew it would. We are now hearing reports from police in Japan that there are 200 to 300 bodies floating offshore of northeastern Japan where the quake was centered. And in addition, we have reports obviously of a ship with 100 people that was swept away in the tsunami wave. Reports within the city of Tokyo and further north of possibly 60 deaths. So we're talking now a death count in the several hundreds as these reports come in. And in addition, George, we're hearing reports this morning there's been an evacuation of thousands of people near a nuclear plant. Japanese officials say the coolant system isn't working correctly. They say there is no leak. Our own Martha Raddatz is reporting that her sources are telling her Japanese officials are very concerned about this. They are presenting a calm face to the public, but they are very concerned about this.
That's right. They've issued a state of emergency in Japan, but they say that's just for precautionary reasons. But as you say, U.S. officials are telling Martha Raddatz that they are very concerned about this.
The focus of the quake was located 40 kilometers below the seabed. Once again, an earthquake with an estimated magnitude of 7.4 hit Miyagi Prefecture 11:32 p.m. local time on Thursday. According to the meteorological agency, the focus of the quake was located 40 kilometers below the seabed, coastal areas in Miyagi Prefecture. People near the coast should immediately evacuate to higher ground. Please, just in case, be aware of any possible high wave.